One of our students asked us about ShareObject and wanted to learn how to actually use them. So we're going to do a really quick overview of ShareObjects, what they are, how to work with them. We're not going to dig too deep in them, and obviously we welcome you to read the documentation and send us questions for our members or even in our public community areas where you can chat. All right, so here it goes. Here's the basics of how ShareObject works like. First of all, ShareObject is very similar to something that's called cookies in other technologies on the browser. The idea is you could save information locally on your user's computer. Now, basically Flash by default enables you to save up to a certain amount of data on a user's computer even without asking them. That's the default. Now, how could we see that? First of all, I'm just gonna jump into the folder where this file is located at. And we're gonna see that in the file itself, we'll see our shared file if I just run the HTML itself. And if I right-click on the file itself and I go into the settings, I'll see that in my settings I have here my local storage. If you're not in that folder, if you're anywhere else, just click on this folder area, and you'll see that local storage. Now, historically, local storage enabled you to save up to 10K without asking the user. From September 1st, 2011, which was really recently, 2 months ago before this recording, Flash opened it up and made a default of 100K. So if you're in Flash Player 9 or up, then you have 100K of information which you can save on the user system without the user even knowing or giving you any specific approval. Most users never even go into their Flash Player settings. But even if they do, it would just trigger them a request asking them, do they want to save that information or not? And if they say they don't, then they won't be able to share the information. But we're going to look at that in a second after we create our first shared object. So I'm going to close that. And I want to visit back and kind of show you locally how does that file structure look like. And to find out more about where the file location is, where is that file that's being saved locally on your computer, just go on to our website in this courses page and you'll find the link to the Wikipedia entry, which has a list of all the different paths depending on your operating system. All right, so basically the folder looks similar, so it looks like something like this, and I already played around with it, so I can see that localhost is actually local file that has been saved on my computer, but I'm just going to delete that away. And we're going to start off from scratch, and we're going to see how automatically, as soon as we create a new shared object, it's going to automatically create that folder for us because we're in a local storage. Now, if it was YouTube, we would have your youtube.com. If it was any other site, we would see that every site has their own local storage information that automatically, not every, but a lot of them, that saves some information about you, the user. All right, so if we jump now into the Flash Player itself, let's just start building it and seeing how we actually create them. And how do we access them, which is immensely easy, very, very easy. So the first step is let's just go into our ActionScript panel. And in our ActionScript panel, what I want to do is I want to just create here, I just want to create here a variable. I'm going to call it SO for shared object. Now, shared object, contrary to other objects that we've seen previously where we created a new of that type of object, shared objects, we don't create a new one. And the logic behind it, obviously, is we're really not creating a new thing. We really want to fetch something locally. Now, the way this works is this way. We call the shared object class, and then we call our get local. By the way, there's such a thing as get remote. We're not going to get into that. That's for getting files that are saved on the server itself, and it only works if you have a Flash media server. All right, so we're going to select the get local. And the get local has three options. We're only going to look at the first one right now. And the first one is really the name of the file that we want to fetch. We don't have to put the dot extensions. We just give it a name. So for example, let's call this everything FLA. So everything FLA is going to be our file name. This is going to be the name of our local storage. Now what Flash is going to do is going to look for that file. If it cannot find that file, it will create it. So it's automatically creating. We don't have to ask to create it. You don't have to check if it exists or not. It will automatically create it if it does not exist. Now, local path, the idea behind local path is, first of all, your shared object could only be shared in the same domain. Now, if you have a lot of different Flash files and you want to share between the shared objects which are in the same domain, for example, localhost, anything in localhost is the same domain, right? Anything you're doing locally on your computer is in the same folder. Now, let's say if you have if your site is everything FLA, and you have in your site three different Flash files, and you want them to share information with each other, you could do it easily. Now, they might be in different folders, and because they're in different folders or different subfolders, a good thing to do is always just set here your path to be just the root and the beginning of the path, making sure that you're always fetching the files from the root. Now, because we know we're not working with a secure protocol, and we don't even want to get into that, so we're just going to skip that third parameter. Let me just open this up a bit so we could see it all in one line. So that's it. We got our local file, and even if we just do your little trace, SO data, which that's where all our data is going to be located into. If we just do that SO data and we just run this, we're going to see that we have your an object already. It's an empty object. And if we just flip and go right into that area, we'll see that we already have a local host now, and it's kind of getting ready to save some information. We never saved anything, but it already created a folder for us. So let's start creating information and saving information. Very easy. So first of all, I could just go to my data and let me just create a variable. Let's say, let's just call this me equals Ben. All right, now the next step that I want to do when I'm complete and I'm done with adding all the information that I want to do, I want to tell Flash, okay, now save it to the system. Until now, we're working in Flash, but we want to tell it save it into the system. The way to do that is we just type so.flush. Now, by the way, Flash will automatically return a string. And that string is going to basically tell us we could follow it or not. Basically, it's going to tell us if our mission was successful or not. And obviously, if this is critical information, you want to follow it, because if the user blocked you and it doesn't or you pass the amount of kilobytes you could use, so it wouldn't work. But if we run our application right now, just the way it is, and we're going to do that flush, we're going to see that the file was flushed. It was successful. And truthfully enough, if we just go back into our local host, we're going to see that in our local host, now we have our everything FLA, SOL, this is our shared object, our local shared object. All right, so that really covers the basics of it. Now, what type of information could we put inside of our SO, so in our shared object? First of all, we could put any object. Obviously, we can't put directly visual stuff. We can't put a movie clip inside because it's not going to store the visual elements. But we could put here, if you want to put here a date, we could put here a new date. We could put any really data object, as long as in the end of the day, our file size doesn't cross the amount that the user has. And if it does, we'll see what happens just in a second right now. So first of all, let me just run this one more time. And you might be asking me now, it's great that I could save information, but how do I get the information? So now that we could even delete this information, let me just comment it out. So let's say we're in a different file now, a completely different file. We'd be doing the same exact step in 3. And all we have to do now in line 5 is, let's say we just want to access that data. So just as much as you would access any object in Flash, you could just access the data directly. So then if you depend on it existing or not, you could always have your some sort of if statements asking if you have data inside, if it exists, if it wasn't updated, and then do whatever operations you want to do. Now, I just want to wrap this topic up by showing you one last thing. So first of all, we already have our shared object, but I'm going to make sure that it saves it again, because I want to show you what happens when the user empties out their system. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to jump in right into our browser again, and I'm going to go into my settings. And in the settings, I'm just going to drag the local storage to say, no, I don't allow any local storage. And it's telling me that it's going to remove all information because there is information already. And I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to close it up. Now, if I go back into Flash and I run my application again, we're going to see that something happens. First of all, it's giving me a pending message, basically letting me know that there's an issue going on. Your first file, the bin, doesn't exist yet, so it's undefined. And it's telling me pending, and it really depends on my decision here. And look how if I set it to 0, now it's going to request it only to jump up to 10K instead of 100, which was the default. So I'm going to click on OK. I'm going to allow it, and then it saved it. So now if I run the application one more time, we're going to see that it flushed, it had no issues, we didn't need to follow up on it and see what's going on with it. So those are the basics of shared object. That's all you really need to know to start playing around with it. And if you have any issues, any questions, any concerns, or any comments, or anything, feel free to contact us at everythingfla.com.